The fall 2019 test realm is pretty much here. As of the time that I'm making this video, only the update notes are out. So I'm guessing by the time you watch this video, hopefully it'll be out, but we're gonna go through all the update notes because I can't even log into test realm yet. They're still waiting to release it, but we got a lot of cool things to look through in the update notes. So here we go. We finally get to go into Ultan Tunnel. This was one of the teasers that they released. And it starts with mysterious trouble is brewing under Wizard City, and we need all wizards to help discover the source. In this update, we reveal Wizard City underground. Can you solve the mystery of the missing landscaper and deal with what lies beneath? And beneath is capitalized. Also in this update, several new features to help your wizard advance in the world, and coming soon, new event updates. They're going to be updating Beastmoon and Decathlon like they do in most of the test realms since they've come out with those updates. But here we go, the highlights. There's going to be an Old Town Drains instance, and there's also going to be a Golem Court Drains gauntlet. So I wonder if to access the Golem Court one, you have to go into Golem Court, and they have like a sigil somewhere in there, and that's the higher level one. So there's only two. People thought that there was going to be three new dungeons, but from what I'm seeing here, there's only two new dungeons. This is the low level one. This is the higher level one. And there's also this spell writing system, new utility spells that they're adding in, the Backpack Butler, which we'll see. They're updating hatchmaking kiosks, which is really good. Castle Magic update and some of the updates to Unicorn Way, like the beginning of the game stuff, and then like the two events that I mentioned. So here we go. The refurbishment of Wizard City has some unexpected consequences, and now there's some seriously deep trouble brewing underground. What secrets lay buried beneath Wizard City? Is poor landscaper Doug lost forever? And what's with the funny smell coming from all the storm drain covers? Find out in today's big update currently in Test Room. So Test Room is coming out today. It's probably out when you're watching this, but we're going to keep going through the update notes because that's all I have. So here is the actual new instance. They've backed up all of the people, all the landscape people, and they added in a sigil right there in front of the Old Town Hole that's been there for over a year at this point. It's been a while, but that is the instance. And what else about it? Yeah, Doug went in on his own and we have to go and rescue him. So that's what this instance is going to be about. So this one is lower level. This one is only level 15. So this will be the easier one to complete. And that's for anyone that's in Wizard City or completed Wizard City. Then you could do this and get some XP from this quest to save Doug. So that is where that one is located. And then the next thing is the Golem Court Drains. They don't show an instance sigil for this one. So I don't know where this is located. Somewhere in Golem Court, I'm guessing. We'll have to go check that out and see where it is. I wonder if you have to complete this one before you can do this one. I don't know. But here is the new one. We have the new professor that is going to be in the higher level dungeon. So this one says, ever wonder what happens to all the garbage a town like Wizard City produces? Well, wonder no more. Once your wizard has completed a certain sacred tree ritual, so yeah, right at the beginning of Imperial Part 2, then you'll be asked to go to the subterranean sanitation operations with a pesky little trash issue that is going on in the Wizard City drains. Okay. And then we also have the, yeah, it says something about the lost history of the spiral will be revealed. That's what I wanted to know. I thought that this Old Town Tunnel would be a good opportunity for them to explore some kind of history of Wizard City or history of the spiral. It looks like we're going to get that in this higher level dungeon. So pretty much you got to be 130 to, well, I don't know if you have to be 130. Maybe it'd be like 125. To do this one, I think. Actually, no, it says approximately level 130, so I'm not sure. You just have to complete that quest. So whatever level you get to when you are starting Imperial Part 2, you can do this. Spell writing, this, out of everything, this was the most unexpected thing because they didn't tease anything like this. I wanted this to be a thing in Wizard 101 for a long time, and they're finally adding it. Basically, I'm not going to read it. You can read it if you want to, but what it is upgrading your spells. So Firecat here starts at 80 to 120 damage. And if you upgrade it, you'll be able to allow it to deal more damage and even change up how the spell works with the damages. So you start here, you upgrade to level 2, and now it does maximum of 125 damage. Then you got to pick a branch. So the top branch is Firecat will always do 105 damage, and you can upgrade it to do a little bit more damage. And as it's upgrading, it also increases the accuracy. So now your Firecat is way better, and it does 110 every time. You also can do this branch down here, where it does a higher amount of like max damage if you hit that, but the accuracy stays the same, and is like the range. The range goes all the way up to 95 to 145. I kind of like this one. I would pick this one if I had to go between these two, because accuracy isn't that important. Maybe it is lower level, but I would choose this Firecat, this beefy 145 potentially upgraded Firecat. That's awesome. I always want something like this. I think it's a great idea. I hope it's not too difficult to train your spells. And I wonder how many spells you can train. Can you train all the spells? That'd be something to look into. But yeah, you upgrade it, and they've also added in some new utility spells. I think there's more than this, but these are the ones they're showing here. So I already read through this. I'm not going to read through it all. You guys can read it if you want. So here's what these new spells do. They're utility spells from the Sun School, and they're also enchants. So what Daybreaker does is you enchant a spell. It costs 3 more pips than it normally would. So you have to add on 3 pips to whatever spell you're casting. But what happens is next turn, it auto-casts it first and before anything else. And then you also get to cast whatever spell you choose to cast on that turn. So you skip your turn in order to cast 2 spells the next turn for a little bit more pips. I don't really like the 3 pip increase. I think that's a lot, but we'll have to see how it works. But that's basically what it does. So you cast 2 spells. And I wonder if that spell that you cast that turn, you have to count your pips towards that too. Like you have to be able to cast that with whatever pips you earn. I think it said it consumes the pips that you have when you enchant the spell that turn with this card. And then it skips your turn, and then you go to the next turn, and then you do whatever you decided on the 2 spells that you're casting in one turn. Say the first turn you chose bugs. It would be an 8 pip bugs because you have to add 3 pips to it, 5 pips plus 3 and a shadow pip. And then you can cast like a blade or feint the next turn because you'll have a pip. And then you cast bugs. So you cast the blade and then bugs because you did Nightbringer, is going to cast second. So something like that. But it'll be easier to show this in game once we can get the spells. But it is pretty cool. Like, these are cool mechanics that they're adding into the game. So I think there might be more than this. I'm not sure these are the only ones. I think these are just 2 of them. I hope there's more. But those are the 2 new ones. I hope I explained that. But just read through this if you're confused on it. Backpack Butler is interesting because you can search through. You have to buy this. I'm guessing you have to buy this with crowns, though, I would say. Is it in the crown shop? Actually, it says this is from housing vendors. So you can buy this from housing vendors. That's really good. And you can easily just search through everything. Your backpack, bank, shared bank. I've lost things in this game a lot. I have a ton of things in this game. So this is actually useful. I wonder how much it costs to buy it from the guy. Probably not that expensive, I'm hoping. But that is a good addition. The kiosk, the hatchmaking kiosk improvements. These are what we've been asking for. You can now search by talent. And overall, I just think they're making it better. So this is going to be really good. You can search for certain keywords in talents, like shield, and it'll come up with all these. And searching by talent is really good. That would have helped me so much making my last storm pet. But this is a good addition. I'm not going to go through that, but people that like Castle Magic, they're getting an update for it. Also updating the early game stuff like Krakatopia. Actually, for Krakatopia, what they're doing is they're adding 3 purchasable, you know, passes for 3,500 crowns each rather than 12 separate ones. So they're trying to make it easier to buy zones in Krakatopia. So that's what they're updating there. And then they're also going to be updating Beast Moon and the Decathlons, along with some extra stuff. There is some interesting things in here. They are changing that bug with the friends list, where if you're scrolling through, sometimes you just randomly go back to the first page. That's annoying. They're also changing the invisible wizard when you're on a mount, and you only have the mount running around. You don't even see yourself, so they're changing that. But yeah, these are good. So I'm really excited for the spell upgrades. That is awesome. I'm excited for the spell upgrades. I'm excited for the new utility spells, and I'm also excited, of course, for the level 130 dungeon that we're getting, Golem Court Drains. So I'm excited for that. I'm going to be doing videos on all this, probably start with the Dug quest, because I mean, that just makes sense. Like, that's the main one that we've been leading up to, you know, 1 year plus waiting for this Old Town Tunnel to come out. So if you guys are excited for this, please leave a like in this video. Let's see how many likes we can get for the test realm coming up, probably out by now. Another thing I wanted to mention at the end of this video quick is I have a new join button below my video, and this has been there for a little bit, but I didn't add any actual incentives to it yet. Some people had previously been members because I live streamed and they clicked the join button and did that on my live streams. But now it's available just on all my videos. You see the join button there, you can click it, and there's some incentives. I have a Discord now that's going to be members only. So if you want to talk to me, then you can do that. And there's also a higher tier if you just want to be like a big channel supporter, and I have some incentives for that as well. So just check it out if you want to. It's completely optional. You don't have to, but I just wanted to put it there for people that were interested and want to check it out. So it's there for now. But that's going to do it for this video. Just wanted to mention that. I'll probably mention it in one of my other videos too, so more people know. There you go. Thank you guys so much for watching. Stay tuned for more test room content, and I'll see you all next time.